It's like I'm in the fourth dimension and somebody's asking me to describe it verbally. And that's what the fourth dimension is all about, is no words, no symbols, no images, all pure, real energy and vibrations. And if I thought about how cruel of a world this is, I would probably just commit suicide after a while. If that was what I spent my energy thinking about, I would definitely not have any strength left to create music.
What it is we're in sunny Hollywood, California, and we're getting ready to make a record, and somebody said, well, maybe we should make our record in a huge house. And we said, yeah, that'd be great, because then we wouldn't have to go into a studio and we wouldn't have to deal with the anal retentive vibrations of you know, the sterility involved with that sort of recording environment. We could be focused on exactly what we wanted to do, is make the most beautiful record in the world.
We felt that aluminum foil and obnoxious secretaries would just put a monkey wrench into our music, and we didn't want one.
No, it doesn't. It goes.
So talk about the first halfway through the verse, the segue part.
And we're making an amazing, amazing, groundbreaking, revolutionary, beautiful, artistically heightened, incredible record.
If Baron von Munchausen had ejaculated the four of us, being the Red Hot Chili Peppers, onto a chessboard, I would have to say that Rick Rubin would be the perfect chess player for that particular board.
This is a little secret room up here. This is a room where nobody hardly ever is. It's a very nice little room that... Playing the songs through Psycho Sexy, I was, the main thought that I was concentrating on in my head was, because there was this really beautiful girl there at the studio, and I was thinking, if Anthony doesn't fuck tonight, then I'm not doing my job as a guitar player, because this is the sexiest song, you know, that I've ever heard in my life. And a lot of the times, you know, I'll get an erection when I'm working on something, or writing, like playing guitar, and I'll just go masturbate, or sometimes I'll try to hold back because I'll see the orgasm as something that will be detrimental to my strength creatively. So sometimes I won't, you know, I'll see that erection as being my enemy.
But I didn't shave that.
And I shaved my mustache. I didn't shave anything of the chop that I thought you might be interested in. For instance,
how do you know what I was interested in? How do you know I wasn't interested in some of the neck area that you completely shaved off?
I have to withdraw my position as your coach, because he has no coach and you didn't consultate me. May the best man win.
Okay. Yeah, it is only fair because he didn't have a coach. And something tells me you would look a lot different if you had that.
I'm gonna let me mad right now. So something tells me you look good.
Presentation of the chop, it's all part of the chop.
Yeah, but we're judging the chops, not the goatees.
Does head shape come into this at all?
Head shape does come into it, yeah.
Do we consider
taking it? Take it all in. All right, I think I've made my decision. I'm prepared to write it down.
Oh, come on, man. Look at all my chops.
I got it right here, Brendan.
No, wait. Wait, what do you think about foolishly about stopping?
You don't have to tell the judge. You're about to be disqualified.
Fuck you.
I'm trying.
Just like you were disqualified from the fart off when you shit your pants. The judge will be in the room.
I wouldn't let anything at all that I thought wasn't directly aimed at helping my creativity come out, I treated as if it was a knife to my heart. Like William Burroughs always talks about the world as nothing but allies and enemies, and it's important to understand what things around you are the enemies, and a lot of the time your worst enemy is your ego. It's kind of one thing.
So that was the whole coin thing.
Yeah. Call it in the air.
Okay. How come he gets the call?
He's home team.
Oh,
he's from Chatsworth.
That's true.
All right, call it in the air.
That's...
You get to see it first. Okay. Oh. Chatsworth team will be playing in there.
Man, that's tough. That's gotta hurt. Maybe you'll get better next time.
Okay. But real quick, don't see the list once. There might be something that I could do a great Moog part on right now.
The list is, you let me have that today on your own. I was sitting here, something happened, I got it going. Look at you and Ross. Oh, wait, that wasn't Ross.
Oh, look out.
Oh, come on.
I knew you couldn't just be laughing at Brendan.
No.
Oh, look out.
The meanest. I guess I'm the meanest.
I don't know. I've seen Chad get pretty mean for my amusement at the fans. Okay. Chad will yell at fans and push them around just so I laugh.
Okay, the flower child.
The flower child is a group. Who is?
I would say that John is probably the flower child.
I thought it was going to be John.
No.
Okay, the lady killer.
Please.
Between the four, you are the flower child. The lady killer. That's obviously me. The troublemaker, Chad?
Chad is the troublemaker.
Yes,
huh?
We've all made our share of trouble.
We all make a lot of trouble.
What the fuck? So what? 6 inches? What the fuck? What is this?
What are we seeing? Dicks?
This guy puts a picture of his dick in here.
What does it say?
It's 6 inches.
That's it?
Yes.
He's bragging about his dick.
That's good. He must be a damn handsome guy, too.
That's ridiculous. Listen to this guy.
Ladies, don't pass this one up. I am for real.
It's not so much the political record as it is a socio-political one.
Who said that?
Candle? At this point, we're almost on a snowball. I mean, we're just rolling through. The band, we have the recognition. We've got the credibility. We've got the fan base. And we have everything going for us. Really shouldn't be anything in our way. Where it's going is, I feel it's going straight up. I mean, it's going to get as big as it could possibly get.
And plus, like you said before, we're just about as lucky as they come at this point. I mean, how many, you know, musicians get to come and live in the palace and make a record? We're very fortunate.
Although Led Zeppelin used to record in castles in Scotland and Ireland.
And on hills.
On
in the middle of beautiful country
and on hills. any closing remarks?
I'm just loving the stretch on the Boom Girl again over there. She's stretching out with like that, and she looks like a beautiful creature of love, goddessness, creation.
When you got a clean smile, you walk with style. You can be naked with your brain. In your pussy, I'm coming, and I love you. I always had to.
I didn't hear what you said, I'm sorry.
Let me just do it one more time.
All right, man.
This will be the, because I was going, and I'm just going
to
go.
Let's just try to nail it naturally.
Yeah.
Take it from there.
Sir Psycho! Sir Psycho!
I think we should both do the same part, and then on this next track, do the harmony, both of us.
Okay.
So I'll sing
it. No, let me put this thing out, but tensing up a little bit.
So psycho. So psycho, so psycho, yeah!
gonna overthrow my Hollywood. So paperboy says you are bad. Child of mine will be confused. It's plain to see we rock the groove. If you don't like it, time to move.
Like that whole thing, like up past the wrist.
Just swallowed it.
Amazing. And the girl's just laughing, standing on her head though for like 5 minutes.
Whoa.
And then when the girl takes her fist out, this is the most amazing part. And we're just standing up here like,
ooh.
And then she takes her fist out and the girl's pussy is just a black hole.
Just stretched.
You've never seen a pussy that looks like this. It's just wide open and it went. Amazing. It was just a black hole.
It's like, honey, you're gonna have no trouble having kids.
And it was staying open by itself, and you've never seen a pussy just naturally stay that
completely dilated.
You have to go and wide and push your nose like this to make it close. Close that pussy, right?
Oh god, I'd like to see that.
Yeah, it was fantastic. She was a fucking genius.
She was a genius.
She was really nice too.
That girl was artistically talented.
Totally nuts. This is amazing. She's a fucking genius. Totally insane, too. I wonder if she still works there now that Artie's dead.
I don't know, maybe they like get stretched to a limit or they just...
She told me she does performance art.
Oh. Yeah.
No, I mean, like, that's what else she does. Aside from the Mitchell Brothers, she does her performance art. I thought it was great.
God, I feel like just flying up there.
She's really nice. It sounds funny, but...
Oh,
she was just really nice.
Some of the nicest people.
And really interesting, too. Like... Just no morals whatsoever, yeah. Which is great.
You know,
I mean, what's the point of that in this day and age after Hitler and after all the shitty fucking shit?
Exactly.
No morals whatsoever, just fucking get fist. It's great.
Just getting fisted in public for money, that's something rad. Some of the most interesting people I've met are strippers.
She has such a sweet voice. And when I hear it, I start missing her, but I know that's just my self-destructive side, because there's only one thing to concentrate on now, and that's the music. It's like concentrating on a cow if you're a farmer. In the old days, if you had like girls who ran all the time, and you know, and people screaming in cars and lights and billboards and televisions and news media and police, the farmer wouldn't be able to concentrate on just the cow like he could. Since I'm granted the privilege of actually being able to concentrate on one thing for these couple months, really make the most of it. The pitch isn't the problem. It's just on rhythms, you should just lock up more and emphasize the right one, so let's just sing it once. Or listen to me sing it once.
Okay.
Three, four. Under the bridge downtown is where I drew some blood. Under the bridge downtown, I could not get enough. Under the bridge downtown, forgot about my love. Under the bridge downtown, I gave my life away. We're going to go back to life as actual human beings instead of monks. And I've never taken anything so seriously in my life. And I've never been so proud of anything that I've ever done, because I've always felt like I was a failure. And now we've done something as a band of friends that I'm 100% proud of. So it's a very sentimental time, but try to be strong and just get my shit together. Fuck, how am I gonna do this? Fucking somebody may be the most beautiful experience in the world, but I personally wouldn't want to fuck even the most beautiful girl in the world for, like, you can only fuck her for so long. Like, what may be a beautiful sexual experience in an hour, you may not want it to go on for 7 hours, or it wouldn't be as beautiful. It's like, now is going to come the time to go on tour, so that's just another thing. It's not like I'm going to miss anything.